as hers.
We are now in
the sun, so you guys can see.
Everybody, it's the next day and we are now on our way to our, I would say, official last stop, because then after this stop we are going to come back to New Jersey and then going back to Berlin. But yeah, we are now at the car rental and this is the one we got. We got a Jeep. I'm excited because we are now on our way to our last stop for this summer vacation as a family, because I am still gonna go to other places. But yeah, I guess I'll see you on the road. Hello everybody, we are now in Canada. That's our next destination and my other camera for some reason won't work. It broke down. It doesn't turn on anymore. You cannot film anything with it. I don't know why. And it's so annoying. Anyway, we are now in Canada and we still have a few hours to drive. That's what's happening. We are here at my Lola's place at last. Good morning everybody, it's the next day and my other camera is still not working, but it doesn't matter, I'm now with my family. I didn't mention why we are here in Canada. Today is the 22nd of August and last year, on the same day, my grandfather passed away, so it's the first year anniversary of his death. That's the reason why we're here, and that's also one of the reasons why I may not really be vlogging, but I'll try to vlog something for you guys. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, we're just gonna have breakfast.
Yeah, but now you should do it so much.
Feel my lungs with sweetness, and you fill my head with you. Shall I ride?
Hey guys, so today I just spent a lot of time with my grandmother, my Lola, and yeah, now I'm just looking at some clothes of my grandfather from my Lolo, and I'm gonna clip some of it, but yeah, because I don't know, I don't really feel like vlogging, there's not much to vlog. So I thought I'd just film a bit how I'm trying on his clothes, because his clothes, he has good clothes. And yeah, I guess that's what I'm gonna show you guys now, so enjoy!
God, there's nothing to compare to you. You're so holy and you like no other. Oh
oh God, hey, nobody else can do what you do. You rule earth and sky, holy father. Yeah, all your ways are right, all you say is true. Oh God, yeah, there's nothing like you. Every day of my life, every beat of my heart, God, I wanna be and only for you.
Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed that. It's 1 year ago that my grandfather passed away, my Lolo, and I think everybody finds their way to grieve and to say their goodbyes. And since I live in a different country, obviously you know that I was not able to come here to Canada to visit and to be here at his funeral. I expect for myself to cry more. I mean, I did cry, but like now when I visited him, I didn't feel like crying. I just felt inner peace. I had a peace within me. And also now when wearing his old clothes, and yeah, I feel peace. Still in a way I didn't feel that came to terms already. So I was thinking, what can I do? So I think this is my way. I talk more about him and show a few things of him in a video, and I know some of you might find it strange or it's weird to you guys, but to me this is something that I personally feel that is best, the best way for me to part ways and to say goodbye and just to remember him by, because he was a very creative person. My Lolo was a great artist. He could draw very good. He could call, like, yeah, his skills in drawing and sketching were so good. His handwriting is so beautiful, and he loved to read. He loved to read a lot and watch a lot about history, geography, and the animal kingdom. He was so interested, and I seen so many things, so many traits of that in me. My grandfather was very loyal, very humble. He told me stories of how to always choose to love. He always told me, David, love is not just a feeling, not an emotion, but he told me, David, love is a decision, because you have to decide to love someone and to stay committed to that person. And that's the only way to be married to the same woman for in their case 66 years. The way he spoke about the family, how important family is, it's just, I can really see that also in me. And yeah, he was just a loving man. And I can tell you, sa lahat ng mga kapatid ng lolo ko, mahal na mahal niya po kayo lahat. I cannot describe in words how much he loves his siblings. You really have a great brother. I have a great lolo. He taught me so many things, so many important values and morals for life. And obviously he had a great fashion sense. Yeah, all I can say is that love your grandparents, love your aunties, your uncles, your cousins, your parents, your siblings, your family, friends, anybody who's close to you, especially people that are related to you, or people who are always there for you. Love them and love them and show your love. Don't just love them in silence, but show your love to them while you still can, because you never know. Okay, now that I have said all of those things about my grandfather, I want you guys, if you are able, to just take this time to give your grandfather a hug or your grandmother. Give them a kiss, tell them I love you. Or if you cannot, you're not in the same place, write them an email, give them a call, and I'll just wait. You can press pause and then continue watching. So do what I just said. Okay, so now that you've done that, don't keep it at one time. Keep on doing it on a regular basis.
Good morning, everybody.
It's the next day.
And we are now having breakfast. Guys, service is done. It was a great service, and this is the church that we go to here in Woodbridge when we're in Canada. So if you're looking for a church, go here.
Hey guys, I am now with my tita and my cousin. We're gonna meet other cousin. We're at the subway station. We're going to the CNE. So see you guys there. Hey guys,
oh,
we are now
Which line?
I think I'll just let you guys. We are now at St. Patrick's and we're gonna have dinner. I'm not feeling well. I think I'm getting too old for rides. Anyway, we're gonna have dinner now and I hope you guys are having a great day. Comment below. Are you in your early 20s and are you already getting dizzy and stuff when you go on rides? Let me know, because I'm just curious if it's just me or if it's an actual age thing. I mean, I don't have to throw up or anything, but I'm just not as... I don't enjoy it as much as I did when I was younger. So yeah.